In a previous video, we talked about the negative feedback mechanism. Now, in this video, we will focus on the positive one. If you haven't watched the previous video yet, please go and watch it first, then come back and watch this one. It will make this one much easier to understand, because the positive feedback mechanism is pretty much the opposite of the negative feedback mechanism. So you will be able to compare them. This type of feedback mechanism is less common in our body than the negative feedback mechanism. Actually, the positive feedback mechanism only occurs during normal childbirth or in blood clotting. Later in this video, I will explain how this type of feedback mechanism occurs during normal childbirth. Now, if you haven't guessed yet, I will tell you why we call this mechanism a positive feedback mechanism. On the contrary of the negative feedback mechanism, the positive one works in a way that increases the original stimulus. It reinforces and strengthens the change that is causing a homeostatic imbalance in our body. Crazy, right? Why would our body do that? And how does intensifying the change bring us back to homeostasis? Well, you will see how with the following example. As we mentioned before, normal childbirth uses the positive feedback mechanism. First, the contraction of the wall of the uterus forces the head or the body of the baby into the cervix. This is the internal stimulus that increases the stretching of the cervix, hence causing a homeostatic imbalance. This change is detected by the stretch-sensitive receptors in the cervix that will send nerve impulses to the brain. The brain will interpret this input and release oxytocin into the blood. The oxytocin released will increase the contraction of the muscles in the wall of the uterus. These contractions will push the baby farther down the uterus and will stretch the cervix more. This stretching decreases after the birth of the baby, hence breaking the positive feedback mechanism and bringing the variable back to homeostasis. Now, why is it a positive feedback? Simply because the increased stretching of the cervix, which is the stimulus, causes the release of the oxytocin that increases the stretching of the cervix more. Therefore, it strengthens the stimulus. Now, this was everything for the positive feedback mechanism. I hope you understood everything related to the positive and the negative feedback mechanism. And if you have any question, leave it in the comment and I will answer it as soon as possible. Bye!